Hey guys, I'm Evelyn from Vimo 3D Library. Today, I'm going to show you how to use roughness maps and metalness maps in CLO. By utilizing roughness maps and metalness maps, you can add a sense of reflection. So, let's start with what exactly roughness map is. Roughness map is a map that displays how rough the surface is. It allows adjusting the reflection and roughness level of the surface. In a roughness map, areas which are closer to black appear smooth and reflect light more strongly. On the other hand, areas that are closer to white appear rough and show weaker reflection and glossiness. Let's see how it works in CLO. If the roughness is set to intensity, click the drop-down and change it to map. Click on this icon next to roughness. Now, let's input the value. When the value is completely lowered, the roughness of the surface disappears, resulting in a smooth surface with strong reflection. Let's try the opposite. Now it doesn't look smooth and there's no reflection. Next, I'll show you how to express reflection only in specific areas using a roughness map. I'll lower the roughness parameter to 50 and raise the intensity value high. You can see there's reflection on black areas of the roughness map. It means that reflection intensity and roughness map affect each other. By changing the roughness value, the surface can show a different look even if the reflection intensity remains the same. Let's click on invert. When you use the invert function, areas that didn't show reflection will display strong reflection. Invert is a function that reverses the reflection areas and rough areas of the surface. Now, let's move on to metalness map. Metalness map is a map that represents the metallic properties of the surface. In a metalness map, white areas present strong metallic properties, while black areas look non-metallic. Let's see how it works in CLO. Click on this icon next to metalness. When you open the map, the default setting is 0. Let's input the value. When you raise the metalness parameter, the surface looks metallic. As you lower the parameter, it gets less metallic. Now, let's apply the roughness map that I explained to you earlier and see how the fabric surface changes by adjusting those three parameters: roughness intensity, reflection intensity, and metalness. Let's reload the roughness map and adjust the values to create overall reflection. I'll raise the metalness. It displays strong metallic properties and reflection. Let's raise the roughness value to make the surface look rough. Now you can see that only star patterns show strong reflection. Let's lower the reflection intensity here. When you lower the reflection intensity, you can see that the star patterns show slightly less reflection, but it doesn't look very different than before. This is because the metalness parameter is set high. That's why it still shows strong reflection. Let's lower the metalness parameter here. When you set the reflection intensity and metalness low, it shows a different look. I'll lower the roughness parameter as well. Now, all three parameters are set low. You can see it looks smooth overall, but it doesn't reflect light strongly. Let's apply them to a fabric. I'm going to use normal and displacement maps as well to express reflection and a sense of depth together. I'll adjust the transformation angle and scale values that we explained in our first tutorial video to make stars look bigger. Please be aware that you should put the same values to angle and scale for all maps. The reflection seems a little weak, so let's change the color. You can find out how to change colors of a texture map in our previous tutorial video, how to use texture maps in CLO. Today, I explained to you about how to add reflection to a fabric surface. Next time, I'll come back with how to express transparency. If you have questions, feel free to leave comments below. We'll be more than happy to answer. We're gonna make more videos about how to use digital fabrics in various ways, so don't miss out. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel. See you in the next video!